love that you said colleague, not competitor, because that's definitely a theme in the AAOMC. It's one of the things that makes our meeting Vision by Design what it is, that makes what our community is, because that's the attitude that our members have, is you're not a competitor, you're a colleague. So I was hoping that you could go a little bit into why that is, because I've been to other meetings and there are other great meetings where people share information, but I've never seen anything like our meeting that has that
You're
strong
so true.
vibe.
Let me, yeah, you
Why is
started
that?
out this webinar or this podcast with Supercharge. I'd say the majority of attendees come from the tri-state area, and most of my colleagues in this area have taken my course. So they are competitors and they are colleagues together, but I don't view them as competitors because when I didn't have people doing Ortho-K, the number one question patients asked was, why don't other doctors do this? Now, that's not a question I get often. The question I have to ask within myself is your child right for my office and am I right for your child? And this works out great because when the sun shines on me, it shines on all of us. And when it shines on the doctor across the street, it shines on all of us. One thing I've learned from doing this a long time and meeting people at these conferences is we all do this same technique of Ortho-K or myopia control differently, and it works. There's no one set way to do it. We all do it the way we're most comfortable with. So, for example, I may like the toys and the snacks. My colleague, even in within my office, that doesn't ring their bell, and that's fine because you know what? A lot of parents don't like that. Maybe they want to go to someone who's more cost effective, who's closer to their house, who doesn't want the frills of the parent conference. I'm not the office for them, and vice versa. So when I go to this, when we have the annual meeting that I hope we have soon, what's joyous about it is we all talk amongst one another and share clinical pearls and say, I do it this way. No, I do it this way. And there's no right or wrong way. Once you get through the basics of the Ortho-K, it's how we treat our patients when they're in the exam chair.
And the perfect example of that was, and I'm forgetting the name of the product, it's not important, but it was a solution or a set of drops, and Carrie swears by it in his practice. It works very, very well. And I remember a while ago we got a shipment into the practice from your practice, and Carrie was like, "Oh yeah, here's the stuff from Nick." And I was like, "Well, why did he send us boxes of, it was like drops or a solution, I think." And he said, "Well, we were talking, and Nick says that these don't work in his practice." And I was like, "That's crazy, because this works
Yes,
like,
that's right.
is amazing in your practice." And it really speaks to, it's like the one detail, one product, one minor detail, or however you guys do things differently. And it's like I believe you were just like, "Look, this isn't working for me. You like it, I'll just send it over to you." And that's an example of the kind of camaraderie that's in our academy. People are like, "I'm having trouble with this," or "What kind of lens designs do you guys use?" I had a patient come in today that, this was the issue. What do you guys think? And I love, that's what we built this whole academy on, was that network of people who are like, "Look, the patient, we want to address the global myopia epidemic, and we want to be better eye care providers, and we can only get better by sharing information and being there for each other."
And I want to give one other example, and I talked about this last podcast, but I want to give kudos to the doctor in this forum that you have, the Academy Forum. I remember during COVID, I post a blog post on how I think this telemedicine is overrated, that our whole profession was focusing on telemedicine, billing telemedicine. For me, my practice, it wasn't working. And someone so acutely said, a member said, hey, Nick, have you thought about how you could use this for your specialty care patients? And that's where the virtual phone conference came in. So you could see, there's like, boom, wait a minute, I'm just thinking so narrowly, coding, billing, conjunctivitis, where this doctor is thinking much larger than me. And it's like, how would this help us for what we do? And that's where the whole virtual phone, the virtual conferences came. So you're absolutely right. We all help one
Awesome.
another. You know, when the sun shines, sun shines on all of us.
Right, exactly.